This honor for me. So first, I would like to share my presentation. Okay. I hope all of you can see my presentation well. Is it okay?
Yes, it's already on the screen, sir.
Okay. So let's start. Good. Afternoon, everybody. It is an honor for me to have chance to deliver my view on nanotechnology and the future of Indonesia as a nation, as a country. I formulate my ideas in this presentation entitled Indonesia from Nanotechnology Perspective, a new way to look at the future of our nation. Before continue, I would like to introduce myself with this video.
Indonesia dikaruniai sumber daya alam yang begitu melimpah ruah. Namun sayangnya sumber daya alam dan sumber daya mineral yang kita miliki belum menghasilkan Indonesia yang sejahtera, Indonesia yang mandiri. Bayangkan saja, sumber daya alam kita eksploitasi secara besar-besaran, diekspor dengan harga murah tanpa menikmati nilai tambahnya. Nah, Dr. Nurul Taufikur Rahman, seorang anak bangsa terbaik menciptakan nanoteknologi. Sang pakar nanoteknologi ini menghasilkan temuan yang bisa menghasilkan sebuah proses yang menguntungkan bagi bangsa dan negara.
Jadi nanoteknologi itu adalah ilmu yang mempelajari fenomena atau objek dari benda-benda atau material berukuran di bawah 100 nanometer. Seperti daun ini, banyak mengandung mungkin klorofil ya, kita nanokan. Nah, ini bisa kita jadikan sebagai obat-obatan. Sebenarnya nanoteknologi itu tahun 60-an itu sudah diangkat oleh ilmuwan-ilmuwan, seandainya kita bisa bermain di bawah mikron, ya, maka kita bisa menggali lebih banyak lagi apa namanya sifat-sifat dari material, dan kita bisa menciptakan sesuatu material baru.
Amerika Serikat begitu mengumumkan bahwa nanoteknologi dijadikan salah satu pilar peningkatan daya saing dari industrinya.
Maka mulailah semua kepada berpikir yang sama. Bahkan Presiden Korea mengatakan nano or die. Itu tahun 2002 itu. Saat itulah mulai booming. Kita ini dianugerahkan semua orang tahu kekayaan alam yang berlimpah, SDM yang banyak, kemudian kemudahan apalagi pertumbuhan ekonomi yang terus membaik dengan tingkat 6-7% dan setiap tahun akan terus meningkat. Ini semangat bagi kita ya. Beri peluang-peluang yang mungkin bisa kita ciptakan itu jauh lebih besar. 5 kalinya daripada peluang-peluang yang ada di Eropa.
Dr. Nurul Taufikur Rahman dilahirkan di Malang pada 5 Agustus 1970.
Baca begini, baca gitu. Terus itu saya lakukan. Karena saya diterima di ITB waktu itu, di teknik industri. Tapi tidak terlalu lama, baru 3 bulan, saya juga harus meninggalkan negara saya tercinta juga. Tahun 90 saya harus, karena diterima di Jepang. Saya selama 14 tahun ya, setelah S1, S2, S3. Dan saya bekerja di pusat penelitian daerah di Kagoshima, research centernya gitu di sana. Dan kebetulan saya masuk ke dalam tim proyek divisi material. Ya, jadi yang ada adalah teamwork yang kuat, yang tertata dalam bentuk sistem yang terintegrasi. Begitu saya masuk ke dunia sistem yang sudah terintegrasi, yang mapan, kita langsung unggul di situ. Nilai-nilai kita dengan yang lain, wah jauh melebihi ya. Meskipun di Jepang sudah terkenal Medatsu Tataki, yang artinya adalah yang muncul itu dipukulin supaya, intinya sih ingin mereka mengajak kesiapan dari teamwork untuk bekerja bersama-sama, majunya bersama-sama gitu ya. Inilah nilai kemenangan mereka sebenarnya. Tapi di person to person menurut saya kita jauh lebih handal gitu.
Okay, this is about me. Okay, let's start. I think in this picture is the nano robot. Yeah, scientists dream that in the future they can create robotics which blood cells swim through the circulatory system of the human body, ingesting and destroying pathogenic agents such as harmful bacteria, viruses, and exactly. Do you know nanotechnology? All of you, maybe, I hope. then what is nanotechnology? I think this is the candy or iPod Nano. Or Nano Riantiarno, Nano Suratno, famous name of artists from West Java, because Nano is a popular name for boys from Cirebon, Cilacap, Bandung, or Sunda. Yeah. Or even not Nano Karno, our previous governor of Banten. Yeah. Okay, well, Nano is a dimension of nanometer. One nanometer equals one per 1 billion meters. Very, very small. If you wonder of how big nanometers, it is as thick as the thickness of the surface of soap bubble before eruption occurs, in which the rainbow appear on it. So the nanotechnology is an ability to understand, control, and manipulate matter at the level of individual atoms or molecules, as well as at the supramolecule level involving cluster or molecules. Its goal is to create materials, devices, and systems with essentially new properties and function because of their small structure. So this nanomaterials should display different properties from bulk or micrometric and larger materials as a result of their size. This difference includes physical strength, chemical reactivity, electrical conductance, magnetism, and optical effects. There are so many phenomena in this world, especially in the nature, that show nanotechnology-like application to be used by animals in their daily life. For example, tiny hair-like projection of the feet of the gecko lizard, spider capture seal, super hydrophobic surface of lotus leaf, and exactly. I think this the application of using nanotitania as a lotus effect. Again, you can see this. So with nano titania, our clothes will never get dirty again. Yeah. Welcome to in the nano. There are so many product nowadays. Many nanotechnology based consumer product are already on the market in Indonesia. Food supplements, sport equipment, our shoes, clothes, computer, electronics, cream, cosmetic, exactly. And right now, over 2,000 more than 2,000 customer product based on nanotechnology are already available in the market in the world. And experts have predicted the very significant increase in the global for nanotechnology based product in the into reach more than 40,000 trillion rupiah in 2015 and will rise exponentially. And the optimist global value of nanomaterials reach just about 1,000 trillion rupiah 2022. Moreover, it is also predicted that nanotechnology can lead to the fifth industrial revolution. This say that nanotechnology revolution will give significant societal impact that equal to four previous industrial revolution in relatively short period, only this very short period. And therefore, a lot of countries in the world have been reaching in investing on nanotechnology, and the investment keep increasing by the year significantly. Well, talking about our country, Indonesia is blessed with abundance of natural resources, including its biodiversity. We are the second greatest after Brazil. This may be used as raw materials for nano-based product, and we are the third most populated country in Asia and fourth in the world, with around 2,060 or maybe 70 now million people, and this is a big and potential market, I think. And nanotechnology can increase the value added of Indonesian natural resources. These three industry illustrate the many area of industry that can be improved by nanotechnology. With this, we can say who controls raw material will win the global. And we will win the global competition in the world, because many industry can be generated by nanomaterials from Indonesian natural resources. Let me give you an illustration on nanotechnology value chains that support the idea of who controls raw material will win global competition in the world. The nanotechnology value chains include nano-enable product composed of nanomaterials or nanoparticles that comes from our natural resources. Each of these chains has significant value. For example, if we can be the producer of nanoparticles, we can benefit a lot. Just reducing the size of the particle into nano has increased the value significantly. Ceramics nanoparticles is about 1 to 1,000 US per kilogram. Metal nanoparticle is about 10 to 10,000 US per kilogram. This increase 10 or 100 or even 1,000 times much higher than raw materials without nanotechnology process. And the consumption tend to increase by the time. Nanotechnology give a significant impact for our agricultural raw materials. This curcuma only 2,000 rupiah per kilogram in the traditional market. However, we can significantly increase its value to be about 500 times or about 1 million rupiah per kilogram while it becomes curcuma nanoparticles for cosmetic or for traditional medicine application. And using nanotechnology, ginger powder particles can dissolve to the water up to 100% like this, without remaining materials, showing you how the great effect of nanotechnology on the herbal product, and of course can increase the value. This is also the great impact of nanotechnology. The mangosteen rind extract nanoparticles can be used as herbal tea with high antioxidant, and therefore can increase the added value of 2 million rupiah per kilogram. Another, here's chitosan nanoparticles from shrimp cell. We can change the unvalued fisheries waste to become raw materials for high quality of cosmetic and medicine product. It can be used for anti-aging, sunscreen, wound healing, drug delivery, antibacterial and insecticide. And of course, the increase of the value of this product. Another also, we can change the iron sand to nanoparticles, black oxide, nanoparticles for toner laser printer or a copy machine. And of course, significant value. So with nanotechnology, natural resources can be significantly enhance their added value. Also, of course, such as avocado, cucumber, and so on by nanotechnology to be extracted and to be used for many things, for soap, for medicine, cosmetic, and for supplement product, and so on, for food supplement product and others. We already developed research, make so many research, and this is more than 50 products already in the market. Using nanotechnology. The value of nanotechnology can be illustrated as follows. A farmer of curcuma need to produce 5 tons curcuma to buy a super slim laptop. This, but I can get that laptop with only 5 kilogram nanopowder of curcuma that I produce from less than 7 kilogram dried curcuma that cost me only 70,000 rupiah. So I can buy a 10 million rupiah laptop with only 7,000 rupiah. Ladies and gentlemen, everyone, you may use curcuma containing cream for your beauty care 2 or 3 times a day. Then you have to buy this product every time. While how often do you buy a laptop once in 2 or 3 years? To make this super slim laptop, you may need to invest trillion of rupiah. To reap similar value added, you only need to give me billion of rupiah to produce nanoparticles of curcuma. With that illustration, then we Indonesia will choose which one. Establishing a laptop factory, which we may not win competing with other country, or pushing the establishment of herbal factory with very high value added. This mobile phone can be purchased by maybe about 2 million rupiah, where I can buy that also with only 1 kilogram of mangosteen rind nanoparticles. Again, we Indonesia will choose which one. Establishing a mobile phone factory, which we may not win competing with other country, or pushing the establishment of a herbal factory with very high value added. Next, I will show you about the revolution in agriculture industry using a nanobarbell machine.
Today we will be exploring one of the leading technologies of Japan. In particular, we have a technology called nanobubble water. This technology was actually introduced approximately 3 years ago at the Aichi Expo. There was an unusual fish tank that amazed so many visitors. Snapper and carp were swimming together in the same body of water, which is impossible in the wild. The answer to this secret is the oxygen nanobubbles. As of today, in the nanobubble water, all types of fish have lived together for nearly 3 years and counting without any problem. They are very healthy and even grow faster than if they were in their natural environment.
So with our machine, nanobubble machine, saltwater fish and freshwater fish can live together, join together, and they have fast growth up to 30%. And we show you this our nanobubble. We make a startup and they win Think Water competition.
Halo, saya Dedi.
Saya Hardi.
Saya Rizky.
Kami dari nanobubble.id.
Kita merupakan dari tim NanoBubble ID yang merupakan startup mesin aerator berteknologi nano, di mana menghasilkan gelembung oksigen berukuran nano yang bisa mensuplai oksigen di tambak udang ataupun tambak perikanan. Dan kita integrasikan dengan IoT system yang bisa Anda akses pada aplikasi smartphone Anda.
Fokus kami adalah untuk tahun pertama di tiga site ya. Yang pertama di Situbondo, kemudian yang kedua di Jakarta, yang ketiga di Cilacap.
Untuk komoditi saat ini kita sedang penerapan di Udang Faname. Kedepan kita akan uji coba ke ikan kerapu, kemudian ke bidang pertanian ada hidroponik juga kita akan coba seperti itu.
Selamat.
This is our startup from our research result of NanoBubble. They also to be winner as in Wirausaha Mandiri competition.
Kami persilahkan ke atas panggung Dedi Cahyadi.
Selamat malam Indonesia, perkenalkan saya Dedi, CEO dan co-founder dari NanoBubble.id, startup penerapan teknologi nano untuk mampu meningkatkan produktivitas budidaya perikanan di Indonesia. Pak Wendy dan Pak Nawawi di Situbondo mengalami kegagalan panen hanya 2 pekan menjelang panen itu terjadi. Dan 60% lebih masyarakat di Indonesia mengalami kegagalan panen. Maka kami dan tim membangun suatu mesin yang mampu menghasilkan gelembung berukuran halus, NanoBubble namanya. Apa dampak dari NanoBubble? Pertama, oksigen meningkat signifikan. Pernah kita 2 kali lipat di Situbondo. Yang kedua, kita mampu meningkatkan produktivitas hingga 100%. Dan yang ketiga, kita meningkatkan daya tahan dari serangan virus dan penyakit. Saat ini kita mencoba mengaktivasi lahan-lahan marginal di penduduk masyarakat pesisir yang menguasai 32% kemiskinan di Indonesia. Oleh sebab itu, mari dukung NanoBubble untuk membuat petani dan udang lebih bahagia. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Jadi untuk pemenang terfavorit. Selamat kepada Dedi Cahyadi untuk pemenang terfavorit, terbanyak.
Yes, our startup that has become a winner in the 2 competition, very prestigious competition in startup competition in Indonesia. And this NanoBubble can revolution agriculture revolution by using NanoBubble. So we can produce NanoBubble nitrogen and oxygen in water and in high concentration and can be replacing urea fertilizer. I think in the near future this urea fertilizer factory is replaced by NanoBubble machine, our NanoBubble machine. Next, this attack that the moderator said in the previous.
Inilah Nurul Taufikur Rahman.
Saya Nurul Taufik Rahman, peneliti tua dari LIPI. Saya ingin membasmi COVID dari bumi Indonesia.
Pemerintah menyatakan pandemi ini sebagai bencana nasional.
Virus corona memang belum hilang dari Indonesia. Bahkan jumlah penderita yang positif telah melampaui angka 100.000 orang. Menurut laporan dari WHO, virus COVID-19 bahkan dapat menular melalui udara atau disebut dengan istilah airborne. Hal ini membuat lingkungan dengan sirkulasi udara tertutup seperti rumah sakit, perkantoran akan menjadi wilayah yang rawan penularan. Kondisi ini membuat Nurul berpikir keras untuk berinovasi. Nurul kemudian membuat larutan propolis dengan teknologi nano. Setelah mencari ide serta mendapat bantuan dari rekan kerjanya, Nurul membuat mesin pembersih udara bernama NDCM.
Ini adalah nano disinfektor COVID mesin. Mesin ini dapat menangkap virus dari udara dengan blower ini, kemudian dimasukkan ke dalam sini,
disemprot dengan nozzle yang berisi disinfektan, kemudian membunuh virus dan diyakinkan virus mati di dalam sini. Tapi efisiensi mesin ini masih 80% ya. Kayaknya kita perlu kerja keras lagi. Siap? Yes!
Akhirnya, Nurul berhasil menyempurnakan NDCM, sekaligus berganti nama menjadi ATTACK.
Inilah ATTACK, Airborne, sebentar. Nano Trapping Technology for Anti-COVID Treatment. Mesin ini menyedot udara yang berisi virus di ruangan ini dengan mesin blower yang sangat besar, masuk ke dalam sini, kemudian dimasukkan di sini, dibunuh, disemprot dengan nozzle, ini dengan disinfektan, ditambah lagi dengan nanotitania yang dikombinasi dengan UV vis, sehingga diyakinkan efisiensi mesin ini membunuh virus mendekati 100%.
ATTACK dapat membersihkan udara secara optimal pada ruangan berukuran 6x6 meter persegi. Dan karena hak paten alat ini sudah keluar, kini Nurul bisa bernafas lega.
Segar.
Dan Nang Wisa.
Oke, the nano tsunami is gaining height. We have to prepare before we got swept over. And for your information, the player of nanotechnology is not a gigantic industry, but small and startup companies that's spun up from university or research center. Because the barrier entry of nanotechnology business is the technology itself, not about capital or money. Let's join hand in hand to develop this nanotechnology industry and business for our prosperity based on our very rich natural resources. And this our Indonesian dream, the dynamic of global change provide new hopes for Indonesia. It is true that the prediction of world economies about our Indonesia. Do you know European prediction about Indonesia 2050? Indonesia will be the strongest seventh rich country in the world by 2050. This is from PricewaterhouseCoopers prediction. And also, what is the Malaysian thing about our dream, Indonesian dream? They said that Indonesia will be a stronger country.
Tahun 2032, pengamal penganalisa ekonomi meramalkan kuasa besar ekonomi dunia akan berada di tangan China. China akan menjadi pemimpin ekonomi, diikuti oleh Amerika, kemudian India, Jepun, Jerman, dan paling mengheran menakjubkan kita ialah Indonesia akan menjadi negara top 10 kaya di dunia kira-kira 12 tahun akan datang. Indonesia, negara yang begitu teruk ekonominya tahun 60-an. Rasuah bermajalela. Bila kita nak keluar daripada Jakarta ataupun Medan, sehingga lebih 7 menteri telah masuk jail, gubernur berlambak-lambak. Sehingga Indonesia sekarang dan 10-12 tahun lagi akan muncul di antara top 10 negara yang baik ekonominya di dunia.
It's about their dream about Indonesia. And you know, now Indonesia is the 14th in G20, and in 2030 will be number 7. And the income per capita year by year is increased 2030 maybe to or three times of now. And the, you know, the economic growth of Indonesia before COVID, I think more than about 5% is the higher in ASEAN. And the key economic drivers of this phenomena is because our demography, and also we reach of an abundance of natural resources and also infrastructure, and also rise of customer spending power of Indonesia. So human resource needs in 21st century is have a high appetite or skill, high productivity, quality result, of course, have a leadership spirit, good work ethic, can work in team. This is the basic of all the above competence is work ethics. And so top 10 skills that must be mastered of you, of us, in 2020 is about complex problem solving, critical thinking, creativity, people management, coordinating with other, emotional intelligence, judgment and decision making, service orientation, negotiation, you have to master of negotiation, of course, cognitive flexibility. And so this there is the challenge, I think, for you, for of us, the millennials generation. How can we master nanotechnology to increase the value of Indonesian natural resources toward developed countries in the industrial 4.1 era? So the requirement is reliable scientists, I think the great human resources, great natural resources, best research result, solid work team with entrepreneurial attitude, networking, and the strategy, maybe you can make some startup, join in hand with us, collaboration between R&D center and industry, of course. And okay, this.
Kuncinya adalah inovasi itu harus bisa dimanfaatkan oleh orang banyak. Kita meneliti mulai dari mencari permasalahan, mengidentifikasi, dan menemukan teknologi. Setelah kita menemukan teknologi, kita patenkan. Jangan sampai setelah dipatenkan, kita bawa mati ilmunya. Jangan. Ilmunya, kita cari teman-teman kita, partner, adik-adik muda, yang akan menjalankan usaha itu untuk produksi. Sehingga bisa diproduksi dan dimanfaatkan oleh orang banyak.
Semoga ke depan semakin banyak lagi kolaborasi antara ilmuwan dan pengusaha demi Indonesia Jaya.
With nanotechnology for our natural resources, this illustration technology trend can be changed, become like this. So it's, we are in the first train. Let us collaborate and make synergy for nanotechnology for the world. Last but not least, I will close my
presentation. Saya ingin memaknai dari konteks ini bahwa membangun bangsa ini harus, ya seharusnya ini peran kita sudah jelas. Mari kita, otak kita ini kita agak sedikit peras lah gitu, tanda kutip ya. Masa sih kita nggak bisa di mengangkat satu produk, dua produk, tiga produk yang bisa mungkin berkontribusi terhadap negara kita. Kok nemen kalau bahasa Jawanya itu, kok sangat sekali. Saya yakin sih pasti bisa.
Okay, thank you very much. This all of my presentation.